My name's Robert Bickers. I'm a historian at the University of Bristol. I work on the history of British relations with China. And ever since I began preparing my second book, which was about British policemen in Shanghai, who were employed by the Shanghai Council, I've been building up information about British people who went to live and work in China. And just today, we are launching a new research platform called China Families, which includes some of that information and other records that we've managed to pull together relating to the tens of thousands of British people and people of other nationalities who lived and worked in China between the 1840s and the 1950s. China sounds exotic, a long way away, something which only a very few people would have been involved in. But in fact, there's a China story in many, many British lives. If you had ancestors in the Royal Navy, they probably spent some time on the China station. If they were in the military, they might have served in some of the wars in China or the garrisons. If they were in the merchant navy, they may well have worked on the China coast for some time. But many more. I'm based in Bristol, which is the home originally to the firm H.O. Wills, cigarette makers, Imperial Tobacco, who created a company called BAT, British American Tobacco, which operated in China. And a lot of young Bristol men went to spend 2 or 3 years working in Shanghai as salesmen before they moved back to Bristol. So first thing I'd say is it's almost worth just checking to see if there might be a China story to the family history. There's much more material than you might imagine that's available. It's material relating to estates of those who died in China. There were newspapers published in English in Hong Kong and in Shanghai, which are full of all sorts of useful information and all sorts of not very useful but really interesting information. Sports teams, the casts of amateur operas, the list of everybody attending a funeral, and so on. So some of these are quite difficult to find, and on China Families we've put some guides to how to locate newspapers which are available, or directories, business and residential directories, which were published every year and which cover the whole of China and Hong Kong, in which you can find thousands and thousands of names. You can find sort of this China story quite close to home sometimes. I researched a little book about the 110 men of the Shanghai British contingent who all sailed back together in September 1914 to join up, to volunteer for the British forces in World War I. Half of them went into the same regiment and they went into action together as the Shanghai British contingent. One of these men was called Ernest Fern. He was one of my Shanghai policemen, born in Aldershot, in the army for a little bit, then fetches up in Shanghai, joins the Shanghai British contingent and the 10th Battalion of the Yorkshire Regiment, sees action in the Battle of Loos. Later in the war, he's invalided out of the army with frostbite. Ernest Fern ended up running a newsagent a quarter of a mile from my home in Bristol. And shortly after I'd published the book, I was talking to a neighbour in Bristol who came up with that sort of opinion, oh well, very exotic, very obscure, you know, what are you doing that sort of thing for? So I said, well, funny you should say that, but do you know this, there was this man who used to own a shop in the village called Ernest Fern. I told him the story of Ernest Fern. And after a while, he sort of looked at me and said, Ernie Fern. I knew him. I knew, he was a sort of uncle of mine. He walked funny, had a limp. I said, yes, he had a limp, because he lost his toes to frostbite in the trenches. Oh, he said. So for me, that story of linking Shanghai with a place quarter of a mile from my home with my neighbour there in Bristol. Just shows how interconnected these stories of China and Britain and China and, in fact, the United States or Australia were and are today. And China Families is a new tool to help you try and piece together that China story. So I encourage you to go and have a look, see who you can find there, and then write and tell us what you've found. Thank you.